everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Miley and this is my fast build, my second fast actually. I decided to do kind of like a modern style home. Never really built a modern style home before, so I am trying here and I just decided to do a small one. I think it just ended up being 2 bedroom. Well, it could fit 3 bedrooms, but I decided to make one a walk-in closet, I believe. I built this before I went on my mini vacation during the holidays, right before my game stopped working. So, if you guys see this, those that are on my channel, I did not record this recently. I recorded before I left on my vacation. And I am very upset now that my Sims 3 is not working on my Mac. I got Dragon Valley and some other stuff for Christmas because I wanted more expansion pack for the Sims 3. I know Sims 4 is already out. Oh, and I got Sims 4 too. But anyways, and now I uninstall all of them to install the rest of them and now it won't work anymore. So I'm very sad. I might not be able to finish all my LPs. And I was just getting into my LPs. And I was hoping to create this house for my Black Widow challenge. But I don't think I'm going to get to play any of them. Anyways, to the house. I'm making it a 2-story and I'm trying to figure out how to do a skylight here. So you guys are going to see me putting up a skylight, trying to figure it out. I think this is my first time using a skylight. I am not sure. Because I've built a lot of houses before, but I've just never really do a recording on it. I had to go and put in my cheat trying to figure this out. And I think it came out quite nice. I think it came out quite nice, not as dramatic as I want it to be, but it came out quite nice. And I'm wondering, since I can't play this right now, if when it's snow and rain, it will get in the house. Right under that skylight is where my kitchen table is. And I don't think I want snow in my house. But anyways, I really like the downstairs, but the upstairs, I think I got lazy towards the end there, so I just put it all together really fast. So right here, I'm trying to figure out like a modern style wallpaper or outside wall decor. And it took me a while to figure it out, but I think I figured it out later. And then I realized that I need a bigger porch to, because I wanted a swimming pool. But then I was like, I wanted to kind of look rich and whatever, do a swimming pool on the outside. And I had to Google more of an idea, because like I said, I've never really built a modern home before. So I looked it up and it's very boxy, I should say. So I decided to put these little box out and make it look a little bit nicer. And I'm trying to like come up with an idea, like the colors, you know, to go together or whatever else. I got the Sims 4. I bought the Sims 4 because it went on sale. I don't know if some of you guys seen it, but it went on sale for $20, I believe, over the holidays. So I decided to buy it, and I'm so excited. I started playing it a little bit, and the building in the Sims 4 is so awesome. So I think I'm going to start building in the Sims 4 more often. But, well, I'm going to have to because my Sims 3 is not working on my computer. I brought out my old Windows computer and hopefully that it will work, but it doesn't run as good as my Mac, so I might just have to bring out a video like once a week or on The Sims 3. So I might have to go and play The Sims 4 because I love the way The Sims 4 download right now. I know this is a Sims 3 build, but I just keep talking about Sims 4 because I just got it and I love how fast it load and how non-glitchy it is so far. I only got the base game so far, but I already fell in love with the build. Here I am again trying to figure out the color of the house. Because I see a lot of modern home are like black and white. And I tried the black and white, but I did not fill it at all. And I used tiles right here, and boy, it looked hideous. And then I tried to change the style a little bit, and I still wasn't feeling it. It's just, I don't know. See, I even tried to do just one line of black and then the rest white. White, but I still didn't like it. And so I decided to go with this seashell. And I don't know, I look at this and just remind me of seashells. But I decided to go this way and do spots of black. I think I did spot of black. I think I changed this around. Because, yeah, this does not look good at all. Oh, yeah, I did do it like this instead. I decided to do the windows instead. Keep the house white. I think I'm gonna change that tower to the left over there, yellow or orange. Anyways, so I went and did where the windows are supposed to be, where the blocks there are sticking out. I went to do the windows and change it to black. And it looks nicer once I put the windows in there. Here I am messing with colors again, of course. Because I wanted to look good. I wanted the colors to pop out a little bit, not too boring. Because I feel like a white house is too boring. It's just my opinion. When I see a white house, it's too boring. Well, maybe if you would put a lot of plants outside and stuff. But in this one, I didn't really play with the landscaping because at this point in time, I was getting ready for my trip anyway. So I just wanted to put record this before I left on my trip. So I had to go finish packing and whatever else. So I decided to just build the house and not even put landscaping on it. I did do the inside though. I love the downstairs. And then the upstairs, you could tell I got lazy. I think I already said that. But anyways, here I'm trying to color the porch here because you notice the house is yellow and black. Thought it was a good idea at first, and then I looked at it and I didn't really like it, and I believe I went back and changed the color. I don't even know what I'm trying to do here, whatever else. But I was looking forward to playing this house because I put a lot of thoughts into it, like how I'm gonna, I don't know, how to explain it. I was looking forward to playing this house because this was my first modern home that I built. So I thought it was like really awesome. And at first I was gonna build a different house. I think I thought I was gonna build like a oriental feel house or something. You guys will see that in the future when I build it. But once I started building, for some reason I end up building a modern home. Don't ask me where my idea got changed or when, but once I lay down the foundation, I just totally changed my mind. And you see here, I'm changing the color again because I just couldn't make up my mind what color I really wanted this house because I didn't want it to be too boring, but then I didn't want it to be too busy. And so I kept changing it, and it took me a while. With building, I really want more expansion pack because I don't have all the expansion packs. Because I wanted to get more of the, furniture style and all that stuff. The houses. Oh, well, you guys just saw me putting two of those walls up is to look at the design to see what I really want. But I decided to just keep this seashell looking thing here instead. This changed the main house to white again. And I thought this looked more nice, like a little bit more fancy. And so I changed it again. So you guys see, I changed the tower to yellow. I really like the view here. You guys see the view? I think I built this. I do not remember where I built this. I think I built it in Sunset Valley, but I am not sure. But here it is. I started to put the windows on there, and I had a move object on the cheat, and so you couldn't really see the windows. And it was driving me nuts because I wanted to see through the windows, not just the wall, because I think once you put the windows in there and you can see it. See, I went and turned off move object, I believe, yeah. See, so now you can actually see through the house or through the windows, and it looks so much nicer. I was thinking, about making different windows on the front here. But then I thought it would look too weird. But anyways, I had to take off the roof so I could see through the house, like more lights and stuff. Oh yeah, I decided to put a stair right in the middle. That stair was my divide away from the kitchen to the living room. My divide away. Is that a war? Whatever I'm trying to say. Right here, I was trying to put a bathroom here, but I couldn't build a wall right under the stairs there, of course. I should have known that. You can't build a wall through the stairs. But anyway, so I decided to make my bathroom a little bit smaller. It's just going to be a small guest bathroom. And I couldn't figure out the layout of the house on the inside because I wanted the outside to look good. But then once I got into the inside, I didn't know what I really wanted. So it took me a while. Like right here, I don't even know what I'm trying to do with these counters. I just realized, I was like, what are you doing? And I like big kitchen. So I decided to make this house a big kitchen, but still modern style on the inside. And I have, like I said before, I've never really built a modern house. So it was kind of hard for me because I don't know, to me, a modern house is like very classy and rich people live in. And then I felt that, why do I keep saying and then? Anywho, I felt that my kitchen was too small, so I had to delete that little bathroom that I created there and extend out the kitchen so I could fit a dining table in there. Because I wanted a big kitchen, but then I still wanted to be able to fit a big dining table in there too. So I had to delete the extra bathroom. And I just decided to stick with this blue and green, I guess. That's kind of greenish. And just use it all around the living room and the kitchen. I figure here, too, that since it's a modern home, that it's kind of like high-techy, high-classy. So they have to have a dishwasher and a track compactor and whatever else. You know, you guys know what I mean. Because not everybody has a track compactor in their house, but I'm pretty sure a lot of rich people do. So I brought the blue down to the floor, and I think I took it up to the wall too. I don't quite remember, but I thought this blue was too dark, too deep, whatever I'm trying to say. And I think I lightened it a little bit. I believe so. I don't know, with the counters and that blue, I just didn't really feel like it was good enough. What was I trying to do here? I'm trying to figure out the color. I think I left it like this. Oh my god, that's just kind of... But I think once I put in the furniture and everything, it really brought it in. I really like the downstairs. I was going to put a little blue on the... Oh yeah, there you go. I did change the kitchen floor to a lighter blue. Yeah, there you go. Because I liked it like that, and because then I was gonna make the wall blue, like a little bit blue too, but I feel like it will be too blue and you'll feel like you're in the ocean. So I decided to just make it white and then make my dining table a little bit a lighter color too. So it will match the blue and the white. As you guys can see there, yeah, I changed the color to a lighter. There you go. That looks so nice. Now that I look at it, it's really white. But anyways, it came out really nice once you put the greens in there, in the decor. If I would have left it like this, I don't think I would have liked it. But every house needs decors. So I really like windows, and I wanted to bring that natural light in. So I decided to put the windows on the back there too and make a back door going outside. And here it is, me bringing the greens, just putting those plants right by the window there so you can see, you already start to see the changes. And I wanted to use this plant, I really liked it, but I was like too big, taking up too much room. I'm trying to find a centerpiece for the table here and try to mess with the plants because I've never really messed with the plants since I got Back to the Future, I believe. So I'm just trying to figure everything out, trying to make it more colorful with plants instead. And so I kept messing with all the plants. And I think, yeah, I just was simple, decided to do something simple. And I decided to put these flowers on the walls here because, like I said earlier, I wanted to bring different colors. Instead of coloring the walls, I decided to bring a different, you know, plants, colors inside. So I put those there instead, and then I started to put stuff on the counter. So, like, I've never really done this before until I did my last fast build. And I thought it was really nice having stuff on the counters and the walls. I thought it felt like a real home. Because, you know, Sims don't really just use that stuff. It's just really for decor. So I decided to decorate that too. At first, I put this up here. But then I feel like this didn't feel modern enough. It felt kind of cottage. See right there? You guys can see I moved it out. And I decided to put these cabinets up instead. Because I feel like it will feel more modern than those dish racks. Whatever you call them. Because, yeah, it's just, I think, yeah, this is more nice, more classy. And I was going to put plants on the top of these cabinets. You know, like I said earlier, to bring more color. But I couldn't find any plant that would fit up there. So I think I just gave up here. And I moved to the living room right here. Right here? I believe. Yes. And I was just going to build a living room right there. But then I was like, you know what? I always wanted to do a downstairs living room. Does that make sense? Where you go down into a living room when you come in. So because I wanted to do that, I had to expand my living room. Just so it could fit my living room going down, because, yeah, I would just have a living room that will fit a couch. That's it. So I decided to expand it to make this a little bit bigger, just so I could fit a full living room down here. And I think it came out quite nicely. Oh, and I had to make that room a little bit smaller too, because we had to have room for the Sims to walk around in. I didn't want a basement. There you go. I got the stairs to go down in there. Oh, yeah. And then I realized that I needed it bigger. Because the stairs, if I put stairs in there, then it would be too small. So I spent it out a little bit. And I decided to use the glass stairs. Because I feel like that is more modern. Plus, I did use the glass stairs to go upstairs too. So I feel like that was a lot nicer. And I kind of brought that blue into the living room too. But because I didn't want the same tiles, I brought a different tile. And I think it changed the color a little bit later. Right here is my living room. I wanted to put a TV in here. But then I didn't have a wall or whatever. So I decided to use this TV instead. And so they have to come and go around. Then I realized that it was kind of boring and I needed more plants in the living room. So I decided to use these plants, but then after I put it up, I looked at it. I did not like it at all. I think these are from Back to the Future. I just didn't feel like it fitted in. So I ended up taking it out. And I thought this space right here between the two chairs were too boring, so we needed to put something right there to make it look nice. So I put some greens in there. There you go. It looks so nice already. But the colors doesn't really go together. I wanted to put stuff around it, but then I realized if I did, then they would have to walk around or under the stairs to go up the stairs. They couldn't walk around it. So I was like, I'll just put stuff on the walls to make it look nice. And I wanted to use the seashell thing, but then like I said earlier, if I used too much blue, it would feel like it's underwater. And this wasn't an underwater theme house. So I found these really cute trees, you know. I wanted to bring nature in. So I decided to put those trees in there. And I thought it was really cute. And then I put these branches here. But I think I changed it later because I realized I don't have any windows for my living room. And as modern homes, you like you put a lot of windows, and I love a lot of windows in my houses. So right here, I decided to change the color of the flooring to kind of match the kitchen so it doesn't look too off, so it looked like somebody actually put some thoughts into creating the house or whatever. So I changed the color to look good here. There you go. So it feels more homey. See? I really like this. And then now to this room. I still wanted that bathroom downstairs. You know, the guest bathroom. So they don't go upstairs and try to use the bathroom that belongs to the family. So I made that room over there. And then I was like, you know what? This room goes all the way up. You know, because of that skylight go all the way up. So I was like, why don't we put plants all the way up too? So when you look up, you see plants going up there, and it feels nicer in a way. And I just used the same wallpaper all the way up. And here is where I choose the plants to go up. I wanted something to kind of stand out, where if you stand on the bottom, you look up, you can still see the plants. And of course, these have to be fake plants, not real plants, because they will die. And then back to this room, I believe. Yep. The other side is going to be the exercise room. Because I don't know what it is about me, but when I see like high-class people, I would say, not just rich, but high-class people with nice home, like I feel like they take care of themselves. They like to stay fit. They like to look good. So they have to have a exercise room. You know? So they don't have to take their time to go to the gym. They just get up and go exercise and go take a shower and whatever else. So I figured that the bathroom in the exercise room will be perfect. So the exercise room is pretty small, so I just made it very simple, just to stay fit and look good. Then here I decided to do the bathroom, the black and white. Because, I don't know, I feel like almost every modern home has this black and white thing somewhere. So I decided to just use it in the bathroom. And then I'm just trying to choose wallpapers for the exercise room, but trying to make it not look so oldie. Or, oh, right here. I was like, what am I doing here? Right here, I figured since the dining room was really blue and the living room wasn't blue enough or whatever, I decided to just change the wallpaper right there to make it blue a little bit, just to bring in that blue. And then right here, I decided, oh my gosh, I'm such a dork. Oh, I was like, I had move object on and the exercise machine was kind of outside a little bit, and nobody needs to see all that. And it doesn't look realistic enough once it's on the outside like that. And here is to the upstairs. I was just going to leave it the way it was, but then I realized I wanted these windows to come out of the wall there. So I decided to pull it out. And I, now that I look back, I would kind of wish I left it like this right here. But, oh well, it's already done. And I think it looked nice the way it came out anyways. So, upstairs. To the upstairs. It took me a while to decide what I wanted to do with the upstairs. Because I've never really built a house where the stairs is right in the middle of the place, and then I have to build rooms around it. So I took forever trying to decide what I really wanted to do up here, because like I said earlier, I didn't really have a plan or an idea for this house. I just started building it, and at first I was like, I wanted to do a skylight, a a flooring where they could see downstairs when they come upstairs. But then I was like, no, that won't make the house too small and not enough room to build the bedrooms and the other bathrooms and stuff. So I decided not to do that, and then I just decided to put in the rooms. So there you guys go. I originally thought of three bedroom and two bathrooms up here, or four bedroom, something like that. But I end up changing it and doing a walk-in closet, cause I always wanted a walk-in closet, and I thought it would be neat. Since it is a modern home, and like I said earlier, you seem to be like you have more money in a modern home, and it's nice and classy. So why not have a walk-in closet to put all your nice and classy clothes? And here I am trying to make this master bedroom bathroom here, and I took forever trying to make this bathroom and this bedroom work, because I didn't want it to open to where there's no privacy from the bathroom to the bedroom, but then I don't want to close it off either, because I feel like the wall will make the bedroom feel too small. So I didn't close it off, but then I kept a half wall there. I realized while I'm putting the bed down that I made this room too small, that it doesn't even fit a bed in there. So I was like, that is not good, because somebody needs to have a bed to go to bed. And a bedroom, right? What's the use of a bedroom if it doesn't have a bed? So I decided to make it a little bit bigger. And of course, it's a master bedroom, so a master bedroom has to be a little bigger than the other rooms, right? Anyways, I don't even know why I put a dresser there. I think it's just for looks, because if you have a walk-in closet, do you really have another dresser? I mean, unless you're a woman and you have a lot of clothes. Because, you know, us girls can get a lot of clothes, because I know I do. I love shopping for clothes and making my own clothes, and I don't think you could ever have too many clothes. Just saying, some of those days, some of those occasions, even if you just have an outfit for a day. Anyways, right here, I just put more windows. And I have move object on, so that's why I keep messing with those windows. Then, gotta put decoration, and I figure since it's gonna be kind of like a woman's room, or, you know, a couple's room, they're gonna have perfume or cologne. And then I feel like the bathroom was a little bit too boring, so I decided to put more decoration up for the walls. I don't remember what I end up with. I think I just did that. And then I like the wall decals, so I figure I could put a wall decor behind the bed to make it look like it was part of the bed. And then I think this was the idea, how I got the idea to make a walk-in closet, is because I saw these. I don't know what expansion pack this was from, but I've never seen them before. I don't know what I've been doing this whole time, but I've never seen it before. And so I saw it and I was like, oh my gosh, a walk-in closet. So that's why I decided to do a walk-in closet, because I wanted to use that, and I don't know. Because I don't think a walk-in closet is very useful in The Sims, but think of it as real life, it's a good idea. Especially for me, I would love a walk-in closet in real life, of course. And here you go. I just put the arts up, and then more plants, of course. Who doesn't love plants? What am I trying to do here? I am very sad to see this, how beautiful this house is, and I'm not going to get to play it, because my Sims 3 is not working on my Mac. I'm hoping that it will work on my Windows computer in a way. What am I doing here? Even if it's just 30 minutes a day, I am fine with it. I was like, girls like to have more clothes than guys, so I decided to give the girls 2 racks and the guys just 1 rack. Because, you know, we need dresses, we need dress pants, we need dress shirts, we need regular, guys just need, I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, they need half as much as girls do. And right here, I decided that I didn't need my walk-in closet that big. I needed my bathroom bigger than my walk-in closet. So I decided to make the bathroom bigger and cut down on the walk-in closet. Because a walk-in closet is nice and all, but it's just to store your clothes. And then a bathroom, you know, I don't know. Bathroom, you gotta do your business. You spend a lot of time in the bathroom as much as you do in the kitchen. Anyway, so I thought walk-in closet has to have 2 doors, you know, because you have that nice entrance into your walk-in closet, or when you come out, you have that nice exit opening 2 doors and make you feel good. Let me see. Oh, right here to the right, as you guys can see, I don't know where I did that, but I thought I would just use the 3-in-1 bathroom. Because I didn't have any more room to put a second bathroom upstairs. So I decided to just use that 3-in-1 bathroom. It could be a small bathroom where you could just put a toilet and a sink in there. But with playing The Sims, a 3-in-1 bathroom is very easy because you can take a shower while taking poop all at the same time. So I thought it was a good idea. Just put a 3-in-1 bathroom in there. And then here to this room, I thought it was a really cute room, so I decided to use yellow because yellow is a really cute color, and plus, it's my favorite color, of course. Oh, and I forgot to mention, as you guys can see, I'm doing windows again, but the wallpapers are that white color from downstairs. I actually didn't leave it that color because I didn't really like it. I mean, I think it's kind of boring if you have the same wall color all around your house. So, I'm very strange. I usually put up furniture and color my furnitures and everything first. Then I go back and change the wallpaper to the colors I want. And while I was building in Sims 4, because I just started playing Sims 4 like 2 days ago, you don't have a lot of color choices like you do The Sims 3. And I don't know how I really feel about that because it's too much of the same thing to me. In The Sims 3, you actually get to change your own color, the shade of the color you want, you know, almost on everything. It is so nice. But The Sims 4, they don't do that. And I'm hoping that they're going to have an upgrade and do that because that would be awesome because I love my color palettes. And here I am again trying to fix this bathroom. I don't know why I'm taking so long just to fix a bathroom. I guess I'm just picky about how my bathrooms look. But right here, I figure every house needs a tissue box, right? Especially a girl's room. So I decided to put a tissue box by the makeup right here because, you know, so you could have tissues to clean up your makeup and such. And so I'm trying to look for a mirror to put right here. So, because, of course, you need a mirror to do your makeup. But the thing I didn't think about is you're doing it standing up. But I guess it's fine. Oh, and while I was putting mirror up for that room and there for the makeup, I realized that I didn't put mirrors in the walk-in closet. And what is a walk-in closet without mirrors, right? Because you gotta go in there and get dressed and whatever else. So I went back and put those mirrors in there and I thought that looked really nice. It made that room look a lot bigger. And I don't think I've changed this, but I left this chair in here. And I thought it was kind of creepy to have a chair at the end of your bed because imagine you wake up and somebody's sitting at the end of the bed just watching you sleep. That's kind of Creepy. So I don't even know why I put this chair here. I think it's just to fill up a space. I was thinking I should have put a computer here. But I colored this chair to match the bed. And I realized that I didn't really decorate this room yet and it looked kind of boring. So I went in trying to find art piece to put around this room. But I was thinking I should have colored the walls first and then put the art piece, because I think that will open my eyes more to decorate it a little bit better. It's just my opinion. But here I am trying to find art pieces to put up. And I was like, since I didn't put a lot of plants up, maybe I'll put pictures of plants up and it will still kind of feel natural, like homey. I don't know how to explain it. But anyways, I could easily have made this other room a bedroom if I wanted to. But I feel like modern homes are, you know, for business-like people and stuff. So I decided to build a business room. No, that's not what they call it. A computer room, a study room. Yeah, there you go. That's the word, too. As you guys can see, my house is already $82,000 somewhere there for furnished. And then when it's unfurnished, it's $59,000. So this is not a starter home at all. So there you go. I got the computer and the table up. And I decided, as you guys can see, that I put a plant behind the bookshelf. It's because I feel that it would be more decorative doing it that way, so it doesn't look so boring with just the white walls and the bookshelf. And it will feel, I don't know, trying to find the word. I feel like it will feel more, I don't know, elegant with plants inside the room. And here I'm just decorating the desk. Everybody needs tissue, you know, on those runny nose day. And I made this kind of look like an office, you know, just in case like the dad decided to come in here and work on the computer and the kids decided to come and talk to him or whatever. So I decided to put chairs in there too, and so they can read, because there's a bookshelf there, and so people can read if they come in here, so they don't have to take the book and go somewhere else to read. Anyway, so I decided to put up more art. Because, you know, offices tend to, like, have a lot of arts in them to look nice, to feel nice when you're in there. And I think you feel less stressed, too, when it feels more decorated and more nice. I think I should have left it that brown color. And then I did the room and I realized I didn't do... Oh yeah, this is where I decided to go back and color the walls and the rooms. I figured since I made that bed green that I should bring the green to the wall a little bit, so I put that other one in there. You see how when you have move object on, your windows and your doors tend to get stuck inside the walls? Anyways, right here, I thought that I need tiles. In a bathroom, of course, it's nicer. So I decided to put this tile color out here, because it's still the same color and it still makes it really nice. And also tile floors. So it stays the same color, but it just, yeah, gotta put this up. Because you don't want wood flooring in your bathroom, I don't think, because it could go bad, very bad. Then I go back here and color this room. I really like this window in this room. I think it really opens it up. It makes it really look really nice. I think this room is the most colorful room. I think this is the room besides downstairs that I really put some thought and colors into it. I wanted to use some of these wallpapers, but then I was like, it didn't feel modern enough. It just felt classic. whatever I'm trying to say. So I went through a lot of wallpapers trying to find it to make it feel modern. And then I looked downstairs to make sure that I didn't use the same wallpaper from downstairs. Isn't that weird? Yeah, I was trying to make sure I didn't use the same wallpaper from downstairs. Anyways, here is me trying to put colors into this room. And I don't know why I put that blue in there. I think because I wanted to bring that ocean blue with yellow. You know, because like when you go to the ocean, it's like blue water with yellow. I mean, not yellow. I hope it's not yellow. Like that sandy color. So I think that's what I was trying to do to that room. So it kind of fell outside a little bit. And that's why I chose that color. And then here's me trying to figure out the roof, make it look nice. And then I realized is that I couldn't do the roof here is because I was on the wrong floor. Wait, did I figure it out yet? Yeah, I figured out I was on the wrong floor. Then I, yep, there we go. I figured it out. And then I think we moved to the porch here. What am I doing? Yeah, I found these chairs while I was decorating the interiors. I was like, oh, it goes really nice outside. It look almost like a pool chair, you know, not those relaxing one, but like the chilling chair where you just sit and chill and drink your cocktail or whatever. So I decided to put it out here and put a swimming pool right on the deck, because it seems like a swimming pool on the deck feels more, I don't know, party style than a swimming pool in the backyard regularly. Oh, right here, I realized that I put windows on there and I put decorations. So I thought that would look kind of ghetto. So I had to move the decoration because I like the windows going to the living room like that a lot better. Because, you know, people could look in and look at your house and how nice it looked. I think that's a better idea than putting those decorations in there. And I think I'm almost done here. I'm just using these lights from By Debug, the cheat code. And then I think I was done. So screenshot should be coming up here pretty soon. So I hope you guys like this Let's Build. Let me know what you guys think. Sorry if I didn't put too much talking into it. But I am very sad I'm not going to get to play this house. So look forward to some more Let's Build from The Sims 4 instead. And thank you guys for all watching. And I hope you guys have a good day or a good night wherever you live. And here are the screenshots. Bye!